Don't miss out on the special offer from my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They're currently giving you 20% off if you use my coupon code POODLE at checkout, and also giving you an additional 10% coins at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. Today I'm going to be doing a lineup update. I know I did one a few days ago, but my team does not even compare to that anymore. Literally, I'm probably one card away from an 87 overall right now. I know exactly what it's the running back position, but I don't want to buy one because the running back I have is better than the other running backs at a higher overall and even a higher price, so it's not really worth it at the moment. But guys, my team's insane. I don't want to clickbait this and say that I have the best team in Madden because I don't, but I definitely have one of the best teams. Like, I think if you line up my team, I think if you match up my team online, you might crap your pants just based off what you're going to see, because I literally have almost a top player at every position that you could even have right now. At least on defense. On offense, I use more... I don't exactly have the top one just because there's certain players I have a preference for. Because that's offense. Offense is more about what you like, not so much what the stats say. Considering that's what you're going to be stuck with for scoring with. So guys, I'm going to be doing this in my item binder. Because if I go through the lineup, I'm just going to spoil the whole thing. So I'm going to be doing this one by one in the item binder. Show you guys. But guys, before I get into the video, let's get this video to 50 likes for the lineup update. And if you guys are crazy, let's get it to 100 likes. That would mean a lot to me if you could. Show some love for the team. I did a vote on a poll on the community tab, and you guys voted over like 100 votes that you want to see this, so I'm gonna be doing it. Second one, this one's probably like, I'll add up the coins at the end. There's probably like a 3 million coin update. This is expensive as hell, but let's get into this, starting at the quarterback position. Also guys, I've got to mention, go smash that sub button, boys. We are up like 200 to 300 subs in the last 24 to 30 hours. Smash the sub button and the like button. Let's get our subs up. Let's hit 3,000 by the beginning of August. The first week of August, and hit the noti bell so you guys get notified every time I drop some fire content. All right, guys, so let's get into it. So at quarterback, we got John Elway and Tom Brady. I know that sounds stupid, but the thing is right now, so the reason I have John Elway is that I was actually on FaceTime just chilling, and I sniped out the John Elway set piece for 11K. So I just made him. So I could sell him or Brady. I haven't decided yet. I like both of them a lot. John Elway feels really, really good though, but Brady's too cheap right now to sell. So I'll probably hold on to Brady until I can sell him and just use Elway, or I'll just sell Elway when prices go up. His stats are crazy though. 89 throw power, 84 throw short, 85 accuracy mid, 86 accuracy deep, 86 throw under pressure, 87 throw on the run, 86 play action. I won't be going over stats for everyone because that'll get very long and tedious. But the point is, John Elway's a beast, guys. If you haven't tried him out yet, go try him out. He's like Patrick Mahomes, but better. In the sense that they're both very similar builds, but I feel like he plays a little better than Patrick Mahomes did. And then Tom Brady's really, really good. He's just slow as hell. Now at the running back position, guys, this is where my overall is a little bit lower. I got Saquon Barkley, best running back in the NFL. I don't know why his overall is so low. If you compare him to Ezekiel Elliott and Todd Gurley, Saquon Barkley literally is the same, if not better. He's better than Ezekiel Elliott, and he's better than Todd Gurley. Like, stats for stats, like their main stats, he either ties or beats him in most things. It really doesn't make sense, but I think like his awareness and stupid stats are really low. But if I upgraded him, I'd probably be an 87 overall, because my defense is an 87. My offense is an 86. But I don't really feel like buying Todd Gurley for 140,000 just to justify it. His speed at an 83 is literally the best speed out of all the running backs like that you can buy on the block that are 87 to 88s and like that. Except Marcus Allen, obviously, and Tariq Cohen, but those are different stories. Now, coming in at fullback, we got Anthony Sherman. Not going to say too much on him. Just got him for the lead block in the overall. Let's get into the next position. That's boring. Okay, wide receiver. DeAndre Hopkins is a stud. The reason I have DeAndre Hopkins is because I opened up a gold nap pack out of my NFL Epic Solos, and I pulled DeAndre Hopkins. I was freaking out. I have the video up on my channel if you haven't seen it yet. It's one of my first videos in the first 3 days. 88 overall pull. But yeah, I powered him up because he's nat. I might as well. And then Torrey Holt, if you guys haven't got him yet, he's crazy good. Look at his speed. And he's only 87. I still have a 90 to get him too. And he has this really good cam that I'll probably make a video on that's OP. I was labbing it last night with someone, and it's crazy. So Torrey Holt, definitely don't bench him. Don't buy another receiver. Just start his ass. And then Tyreek Hill. Tyreek Hill is a no-brainer. He's 89 speed. Glitchiest card in the game probably when it comes to speed. I pulled him out of my first or second pack opening, so I just been starting him. And then Brandon Cooks is like a good wide receiver four for four verts and people get tired. Now coming in at tight end, we got Travis Kelce. I don't know how I feel about him just yet. He catches really good, but he drops when he gets hit easily, and he's slow as hell. I feel like I want a George Kittle. I'm probably going to get a Kittle at some point. I'm not really a fan of this Travis Kelce. He's kind of just a placeholder for my overall and to have a good tight end. Now let's go over the line real quick. Trent Williams. Guys, if you have to pick a left tackle, pick Trent Williams. David Bakhtiari is a better overall, but his stats don't compare. Trent Williams is the only high elite left tackle that can run block and pass block well. because the other left tackles can't seem to run block. Just don't make the mistake of buying Bakhtiar or Tyron Smith. Go Trent Williams. Left guard, Andrew Norwell, best left guard in the game probably. The reason I went with him is because he's the cheapest left guard. You literally buy his 15K power-up card. You put a power pass in him, and then you power pass his theme builder with 1,000 training. And I have an 87 left guard for maybe like 30K. At center, we got Jason Kelce. I pulled him out of a pack. I was going to replace him, but the options are like Travis Frederick. So Jason Kelce is probably one of the best anyways. His pass box is a little low, but being at center doesn't really... I've never really felt too much pressure coming from the center position, so depends on what people run. At right guard, we got Larry Allen and David DeCastro. I should sell David DeCastro. I sniped Larry Allen out for like 135 on the auction block, and he goes for like 190, so I'm going to rock with him for now. Best right guard in the game, hands down. And then David DeCastro, he is a budget beast if you guys want him. Look at his stats for an 84 overall, pretty cheap. Just don't forget that. Now, going over to the right tackle, we got Mitchell Schwartz. This is more of an overall move. As far as right tackle goes, it's probably better, but just wanted a decent right tackle pass blocking. That's it. I just wanted a decent pass blocker. I could care less about who it was going to be. Not really a fan of that position too much. I need to find a better one, but that's what we're rocking with for now. Now the defense, guys. The defense is where things get serious. This is literally where all my coins are. Like offense, you thought there was a lot. All my coins are in defense. We got Michael Strahan, the best left end in the game. There's no debate. Best left end in the game. His stats are insane. I got him chemmed up. I'll probably power him up if you guys don't have him. I'm a Giants fan. Giants Hall of Famer. Get Michael Strahan. There's really no debate to him. Look at these stats. Everything's high 80s. And his speed isn't bad either. I wonder if he can catch. No, I was going to say it for QB spies. But he's crazy good. So I have the best left end of the game. So that's already one on the line. Just remember my line. I right end, I got Aaron Donald, the best right end in the game. So, and I actually have him powered up too. He's crazy good. Look at his stats. All high 80s again, with some 90s. So again, decent speed. So I have the best end duo in the game by far. I don't think there's any other combination you could do. Now I got a defensive tackle. This is like kind of a throwaway. I don't really use defensive tackles too much. I did this one. This is like a budget beast defensive tackle if you want him. Michael Pierce. You literally just go to you can use your power pass and just buy him. You can buy his power up off the block for like 4K. And then you just put a power pass and you have like an 85 overall defensive tackle for very, very cheap. Quick recommendation if you want one. And then Damon Harrison was my pre-order pack. Just took him just because I needed a defensive tackle. There was no other really reason behind that. Now, guys, remember my rushers, right? Donald and Strahan. At outside linebacker, I got Khalil Mack, the best left outside linebacker in the game, besides Von Miller. This is the best one you could buy. I can't get Von Miller yet without trophies. When I can't get Von Miller, I'll probably replace his ass. But look at these stats. My pass rush is literally unreal, and my run stuff. So I got Mack, I got Strahan, I got Donald, I got Pierce, and now I got my middle linebacker. Let me start with the right outside because I'm sure my rush. And I got Jadeveon Clowney. This probably is the best front seven, one of the best front sevens that you can even employ in this game right now. Like deploy out there. That's literally it right there. These guys are monsters together. When I do blitzes, I literally get through every, like, I don't even have to blitz. If I just do any kind of defense, I get through right away. Multiple sacks on each side. The only issue is deciding on whether I want out Clowney or Mack to blitz, or a rush, I should say, and leaving one of them in coverage, which I probably should find a better defense to avoid that. Anyways, middle linebacker time. We got Shazier and Bobby Wagner. Shazier is the best middle linebacker in the game. Don't let anyone tell you different. Blows away Bobby Wagner. If you didn't pick him as your captain, you made a mistake. He's literally an 86 speed. When you chem this guy up and everything, and with Sprinter or whatever, he's faster than Tyreek Hill with Sprinter. Like, obviously, without it, he's still an 86 speed, but he's faster than almost everyone in the game. I outrun routes. And people are like, how the hell did you do that? My friends were like, how the hell are you picking this off? Shazier is faster than your wide receiver. I could actually run off. The baiting you could do with Shazier is unreal. Point blank. Now, Bobby Wagner, I'm not really a fan of him because his speed's too low, but his tackle, his play rec, his hip power, his zone, block shedding, everything is really, really good. So I let him kind of stand alone. He's like a run stuffer slash. He's his own little island. He does his own thing, and I just use his Shazier because I couldn't keep rocking with Miles Jack or Devin Bush as the backup. And for overall purposes, obviously. Now, going into cornerback, cornerback's really good too. I mean, I could use one upgrade here. I think I'll probably get Mel Blount and probably within the next day or so if I can get him cheap enough. Jalen Ramsey is a beast. There's nothing else to say about him. He hits the threshold for man coverage, and I just need to get his zone up for the threshold there. But to have a guy with 92 press, 90 man, and 88 zone with 87 play rec, 86 jumping, and 84 speed in day one, like in the first week of Madden, that's crazy. Best corner in the game, probably. Him and Mel Blount, but I kind of like, I don't know. Mel Blount's probably tied with him. And then Byron Jones, I see him as Pat Pete 2.0. Him and Pat Pete have the same exact stats. If you had to pick one, I'd probably go Byron. Byron before I get yelled at by Xerxes again. He roasted my ass for saying his name wrong. And then Marshawn Lattimore is just a budget beast. 87 speed, kind of useful for Tyreek Hill type guys who can't really route. He's a good slot corner because those guys don't have good route running. So his coverage is less important and his press and play rec is more about just having good speed on them. And he's just good to have out there in case someone breaks loose, he can catch up to them. Now, this video's getting a little long. Let's get to the end of this. Free safety, Earl Thomas. Guys, another guy you could use your 85 to 86 power pass on. You can get his power. I sniped it out for about 29K. He goes for about 40K, so it's kind of expensive. But if you can get him, best free safety in the game probably right now that you can actually get on the auction block and use your power pass. Probably cost me no more than 45-50K for this card powered up. And he goes for about 120, so definitely well worth it. Now, strong safety guys, a guy I've been trying to snipe for like a week now, and I finally got him. Ken Houston and Jamal Adams. Jamal Adams plays the backup safety, which is very good for multiple sets, like Big Nickel and 3-5. So that's why he's there until Pat Tillman gets his overall up. But Ken Houston, look at these stats. 88 speed, so he's like as fast as Tyreek Hill. 86 hit power, so he hits like a beast. 87 zone, so he's like a cornerback. 87 play rec, like a linebacker. 82 tackle, almost an 80 man. 86 Excel, and he's 6'3". Ken Houston is he's a god at strong safety. That's literally the best thing that I've seen in this game so far. Now kicker, Graham Gano, I pulled him. I'm not gonna talk about that. I think I have Tressway at punter. I have Tressway every year. All right, guys, now let me show you the complete team together as a whole. It's a god squad. It's about to be at an 87 overall if I just buy Todd Gurley, but I'm kind of refusing to do it. But let's look at it as a whole. The offense is crazy. The offense could be a little better. I'm probably going to upgrade. He's going to be a 90 soon. I'm going to upgrade him at some point, and I'm going to upgrade my right tackle. And the defense, it doesn't really get much better than this. The only upgrades I could literally make on this defense are probably Mel Blount right here somewhere, and then that's it. I literally can't get better anywhere else. Mel Blount, and that's it. Like, best ends, best outside linebacker. Maybe Von Miller. I can't do much better anywhere else. So, guys, that's it for the video. I hope this was entertaining. I hope you guys got a glimpse of the God Squad. I hope it was worth it. I mean, I spent a ton of coins. I don't even know how I got this many coins. I mean, I obviously had one of those pack openings, but, like, I didn't think I got enough coins for this. This is, like, something I've been dreaming. This is the team I've dreamt of having since I was, like, 13 under my comforters playing Madden at, like, 3 a.m. with no money. That's literally the dream I've had. So I always had a team like this the first week. I used to verse people, like, how the hell is that possible? But I didn't really spend a lot of money. In comparison to this team, I thought I would have had a lot worse. But anyways, that's about it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the team and for all the money I spent, drop a like on the video. Let's get this video to 100 likes. I might have said 50 earlier, but let's get it to 100. Also, if you're new to the channel, smash the sub button. Hit the noty bell to get notified every time I post. And comment down below, guys, who you think I should change on this team and who I should upgrade and if I'm missing anything. That's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'm out. See you guys in the next video.